Joining us right now on the Steve Malzberg Show is our friend, former federal prosecutor, Fox News legal analyst, and author. And her latest in the author line is a must, which, among other things, talks about cyberbullying and bullying. Hey, Lee Sweel, how are you?
Hey, I'm doing great, Steve. Busy day.
Yeah, very busy day. And, you know, the last time we talked, it was the day of the bombing.
Right.
And you were so emotional, and it was so real, and it was good. It was all good. And you were so worried that your son, who you weren't able to reach until right before you came on.
I remember that. That's right.
You were worried that he was at the finish line at the Boston Marathon because he wanted to go, and he's in Boston, and the whole thing. So now we've progressed to this point. Yes. We have these arrests. What's your take on the arrests as a former prosecutor?
We've got three arrests. I mean, it's sort of a placeholder complaint, which is a title a conspiracy charge, 371, statute 18 U.S.C. I'm got it right in front of me right now. Like I said, it's a placeholder just to say, look, these three had went in. They were trying to maybe help their friend. They got a backpack that contained fireworks and a laptop computer. And I'm reading from the complaint
here. And they got rid of it. They ditched it.
Right, exactly. With the intent to impede, obstruct, and influence the criminal investigation of Marathon bombing. So very, very serious charges, Steve.
Yep. And lying to the FBI, at least a couple of them. Yeah. So, all right. And, of course, the immigration violations, two of them have been held. And that's a whole other matter.
But in
the time we have left, I want to talk about, I live in New Jersey, and you and I have talked about bullying before.
Right.
And your book, your great, exciting novel, which is the latest one, and the first of a new series that you have out, A Matter of Trust, addresses this. So let's talk about the New Jersey bullying law, which you say goes too far in some instances and not far enough in others.
It does. I mean, this has been hailed as the toughest anti-bullying law in the nation. Okay, in New Jersey, it took effect in 2011, and it sounds good. I mean, it sounds like we're going to go after anybody that's bullying on the playground. But the problem is that it's gone in some ways too far. You've got cases where, you know, one kid is being found guilty of being a bully because he was called a classmate a horse.
Right, in Ridgewood, New Jersey.
Right, exactly. I mean, come on, kids are going to, there's no way you can take all of that out of kids on the playground. But under the law, you have to have this distinguishing characteristic, such as their race, religion, gender, physical appearance, or sexual orientation, okay, to make it illegal and bullying. But that's, you know, that's not broad enough in the sense that there are horrible things that can be said that have really nothing to do with race or religion. But, you know, we've got to be exercising some kind of judgment here. And what I worry about with this law is that we're trying to be, okay, we're going to be so tough on bullying. We're going to go after those bullies. And what do you do then? You really going to haul kids into juvie because they call another kid a horse?
Well, that's how crazy it has gotten, I have a 13-year-old, and he's got a great sense of humor, and he likes to kid around, and I warn him all the time, you know, what you say to me, don't ever repeat outside, and just don't say anything outside, basically, or at school, because you know, who the hell knows? I mean, we've gone so overboard. I mean, kids, I'm not condoning bullying,
but kids have
been bullied throughout time. I mean, it's a natural thing. You call a kid a name. But now, the way the law is written, because any characteristic, any distinguishing mark, anything that you talk about, allude to, make fun of, you could be arrested.
Right, exactly. And that's kind of a sad thing, too, when you get to the point of, you know, telling your kid that you can't, just like you're telling your 13-year-old, you can't say anything out there. I mean, that's just nuts.
But what about the other end? Now, you say then on the other end it doesn't go far enough.
Well, it doesn't really, because it narrows it so much to this distinguishing characteristic. So, I mean, wait a second. So if I'm really truly bullying, but I don't fall into one of those categories in the law, then I'm not a bully? I mean, to the point where, you know, we've had kids that have hanged themselves. I mean, horrible stories. You know, Megan in Florida very recently. I mean, there's just so many of these stories.
Yeah, that's what we were supposed to talk about on the 15th.
Exactly. A couple of weeks ago. Yeah. But I don't think this law would necessarily cover someone like her, and that doesn't seem right.
Well, that was a sexual assault, and that was we talking about the right one. Yeah, sexual assault, and then internet talking about it and putting the pictures or identifying.
But see, that wouldn't fall under race, religion. Maybe you could get it under gender, physical appearance, sexual orientation. You can't get it. I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's like that's too narrow.
Look, and we got less than a minute. And this whole New Jersey law was prompted by the adult who jumped off the George Washington Bridge. The Rutgers student.
Oh, it's horrible, right?
Horrible, but Yeah, I mean, to overreact and to put this law that affects, you know, 6 and 7 and 10 and 11 year olds and could ruin their lives
right.
because of something they said is insane.
Right. And I think your point makes it exactly that you're telling your kids, your 13-year-old,
right.
hey, don't say anything out there. Now, you know, should they be getting on the internet and Facebook and having squabbles and fights and calling
No.
Hey, listen,
Lise, I'm up against a heartbreak.
You got it.
I thank you. The book is A Matter of Trust. It's a great thriller, and this is a part of it. This is addressed in it. This is a part of the theme of the book. So check it out, and we'll have you back, Lise. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Steve.
All right, Lise Wheel, watcher on Fox News, reader, A Matter of Trust. We're coming back on the Steve Malzberg Show.
The Steve Malzberg Show.